Hey everyone. I thought that I would do a continuation of the Riley Strain missing person case. As far as I know, they have done their searches up and down the river. They have volunteers from TikTok who found his debit card on the bank. If you want to watch my psychic reading, I did a very short psychic reading based on some information that I found through my own research, my own investigation, so check that out. Today, I'm using my Murder, She Wrote deck, and I'm sorry I don't feel like being on camera right now, but I'm going to go ahead and use the whole deck to shuffle the cards and see what comes out. And I'm just asking Spirit for any clues as to where we can find Riley Strain, who went missing last Friday. Not this past Friday, the Friday before then. Okay, he was last seen on security camera footage, walking towards the river. You know, he was walking in that direction from the bar that he was at with his fraternity brothers after he got kicked out. So what information, Spirit, can you give us in the Riley Strain case, if any? I'm going to shuffle the whole deck and see what comes out. Okay. What information can you give us, Spirit, on the Riley Strain case? Okay, we have someone is a pagan here. All right, that may or may not mean anything. Okay, someone could be pagan. That doesn't mean Riley was pagan. Let's see. Tell me about this. Any clues you can give us, Spirit? Murder, She Wrote. As far as we know, this has not been deemed a homicide. It is still a missing persons case, although if you ask me, I do feel like there's some foul play here, but let's see what comes out. I have a prank here. Someone poisoned the water, and someone is indicted here. So those are some cards that just came out. Interesting. So someone may have poisoned the water he was drinking. It might have started as a prank. This might have been involving a pagan. Someone here, there's something about being indicted, although quite frankly, that doesn't mean that's a political term, but I don't know, maybe there was a conversation about someone here being indicted. Maybe someone had some political views here that came up. Let's see. Any clues you can give us in the Riley Strain missing person case? I'm going to shuffle the whole deck here. Someone is in a coven, so now we have a pagan and in a coven. So of course, someone may have been doing, you know, been doing something fishy here. We have an employee. Okay, so maybe there's an employee here, maybe at the bar that's pagan that was in a coven. Someone may have definitely done something to the water. Maybe this initially started as a prank. We have P&B Rock. So what happened to P&B Rock? Because this is someone okay, I'm gonna have to grab my laptop now because I don't know what happened to P&B Rock. Hold on. Want to make sure that let me ask Siri.
Uh-huh.
Hey Siri, what happened to P&B Rock? Hey Siri. What happened to PNB Rock?
Rakim Hashim Allen, better known by his stage name PNB Rock, was an American rapper and singer. Would you like to hear more? Okay, I found this on the web for sale. Check it out.
That's not what I want. Hey Siri, how did PNB Rock die?
Okay, I found this on the web for how did PNB Rock die. Check it out.
So PNB Rock was... Okay, let's see here. Rakim Allen was robbed and fatally shot at Roscoe's House of Chicken and Waffles restaurant in Los Angeles. Okay. Two people were arrested on September 27th in relation to the killing. One of the suspects, a minor, was booked on suspicion of murder. The other suspect, identified as Chantel Trone, 32, was booked on suspicion of accessory to murder. The police also announced the morning of the 28th that a man named Freddie Lee Trone was suspected in the killing and asked the public for help in finding him. Authorities announced charges against the trio on September 29th, identifying Freddie Lee Trone as the teen's father. Chantel Trone is Freddie Lee Trone's wife and the boy's stepmother, according to Associated Press. Since then, two more suspects have been charged, with the next hearing set for December 4th, 2023. Okay, so he was murdered. All right, so possibly here, but this was... So this happened... Did this happen in Los Angeles? He was robbed and fatally shot at a Roscoe's House of Chicken and Waffles. Okay. Yes, he was the one that... So someone knew his location because he posted on social media that he was going to be dining. Oh, no, the girl he was with. The girl he was with had shared her location with social media. And there was, that is how people knew where he was. So is it possible that this is a similar situation? Did someone share his location via Facebook, you know, the Gram, Messenger, whatever? Did someone share Riley's location, or was there another person involved here, an employee? Okay. All right. Maybe this, they're looking at someone here. This PNB Rock was, there were more than three people involved, it looks like. Yes, two people were arrested. Booked on suspicion of murder. One person was a minor. Okay. So, yeah. Okay. All right, let's see. What else here, Spirit? Okay, we have a kidnapper. Yeah, that's interesting. That has been coming up in my readings. I actually feel like this was a kidnapping that went wrong, possibly, because it's possible he was being held for a certain amount of time before they did kill him. But let's see, there may be a kidnapping here. In which case, is there a ransom? Are they asking for a ransom or what? Maybe it's a kidnapping gone wrong. We have verbal abuse and a pyromaniac here. Wow. So someone here could have a history of pyromania. Someone here could be verbally abusive as well. Anything else from this pile? Anything else from this pile, Spirit? Okay. I'm going to move on to the second half of the deck here, which is much larger. But just to reiterate what we have on the table, I have a pagan. a prank, poisoned the water, indicted. We have in a coven, employee, PNB Rock, kidnapper, verbal abuse, pyromaniac. Okay, those, I picked up some of the deck here. So let's see what else. Let's see what else comes up. Anything else on Riley Strain, Spirit? What can you reveal to us today regarding missing person Riley Strain? Anything connected to his case? Anything connected to this missing person? Please. We have alcohol use disorder. We know that he was very intoxicated. At least he looked very intoxicated. He probably went to a couple of bars. Someone may have poisoned his water. We have a witch here. Again, we have someone as a pagan in a coven, and I'm guessing it's an employee here, but someone here is a witch. Yeah, we have an unethical healer, a star in reverse. So it's possible that someone he was hanging out with or an employee put something in his water. Okay. Now, use your imagination here, because it could be that the water was, you know, maybe there was, I don't know, demon water or something. What was he drinking? What kind of water was he drinking? Was he drinking water out of, who put the water in the bottles? Were the bottles open? Did someone give him the water bottle? Maybe he left his water bottle there and someone put something in it. Maybe it was a witch. Let's see. What can you tell us about missing person Riley Strain? I will happily show you these cards afterwards. We have something with texting. All right, so did he try and text someone here? Was there some texting going on? What can you tell us about missing person Riley Strain? Police, they saw, don't chase. Can I see that? Police. They saw. So police saw something here, but they did not chase. So perhaps there is body cam video here. The police know something that we don't know yet. This may be coming out soon. This is shocking, guys. This is really shocking. What else can you tell us about missing person Riley Strain? I do feel like the police are being very apathetic and moving very slow on this case. That is a message that came through earlier. I have to say what I saw. They may even be hindering the investigation by, you know, the fact that volunteers have gone out here and found more evidence than they have, and that they're still looking on an embankment and they found another body, means that this area is very unsafe. And if there's already people that have gone missing and drowned and been pulled out of the water, please do not walk around at night by yourself like that. But we have a jail warden here. Okay, and we have a window. And we have a bike. Okay, so something involving a jail warden. Did someone crawl out of a window here and steal a bike? Or is a jail warden doing something with a window and a bike here? Did someone use a bike? What is this? What can you tell us about missing person Riley Strain? Someone was under the influence. We have alcohol use disorder here. We have a positive influence. Okay, that could be taken a lot of different ways. We have a dirty cop. What did I tell you? I said I saw in my cards that there was a challenge around a car, a vehicle, a police car. Now we have police, they saw, don't chase. So I'm telling you, there's something coming up here. So maybe this cop here, they purport to have a positive influence, but this is a dirty cop. So a dirty cop is someone that plants evidence. All right, maybe this could be also someone here. I have to say what I'm seeing. If this cop did not like, you know, 20-year-old white boys for some reason, This could also be, you know, racial. There could be some sort of racial thing going on here. I mean, I hate to stir the pot, but someone here is of positive influence, or maybe someone tested positive for something here. I don't know. We have a dirty cop. It's sitting right on top of window. Okay, and it's sitting right on top of the card that says unethical healer here. What can you tell us about missing person Riley Strain? Someone had a gambling addiction, and we have something with elder care here. Okay, did Riley have a gambling addiction? Okay, maybe this is this dirty cop. There's something going on with elder care. Okay, maybe there's an older individual here. What can you tell us about missing person Riley Strain? Someone is corrupt. We have something going on in a rural area. R-U-R-A-L, rural. We have a test subject, a cocktail. Someone is in denial. You know, I did a reading, a couple readings back, and some of these same cards came up. One is titled Uncle Sagittarius Prank, Poison the Water. This is under Neighborhood Watch. And then more recently, I have one involving this test subject card and a cocktail and someone being in denial. Was Riley being used as a test subject? Was he served a cocktail here? You know, we haven't talked about the other bars that he visited. We haven't talked about what happened earlier in the day. What happened earlier in the day? Who was he with? Who were the employees at these bars? Was there someone here who was pagan? Was there a dirty cop involved? Did someone use Riley as a test subject for a cocktail here? And we're in denial of that. Okay. I really didn't think I'd be doing another reading today, but here we go. We have a tarot reader. We have straight. And we have crack addict. I don't know what that has to do with anything. Someone here could be a crack addict. Someone here could be straight. Someone may have gone to a tarot reader here. I'm not sure. What does this have to do? What does tarot reader, straight, and crack addict have to do with missing person Riley Strain, please? We have an apartment. We have a gang. We have that tenant. And we have a school shooter. Okay. So the fact that I said school, S-H-O-O-T-E-R, is probably going to get this reading demonetized and banned and all kinds of stuff. So, but anyway, tarot reader, straight, crack addict has to do with an apartment, a gang, that tenant, and a school. So maybe the cards are alluding to someone here who has a very troubled life, okay? Someone here could have been in a gang, okay? They may have been a very bad tenant. Okay, this person may have a history of coming to school quite strapped, you know? So what else can you tell us about missing person Riley Strain? Any messages that you can tell us? There is an auto theft here. Did someone steal a cop car or did someone steal a car? Likes younger men. Someone likes younger men. We have father. We have a cover up. We have elementary school and we have a prostitution ring and we have a male. So was Riley kidnapped here by someone and is there something being covered up? Did someone like younger men? Is he in a prostitution ring? Was he kidnapped and forced into a prostitution ring? Is someone doing this to put their kids through school? I don't know. What can you tell us about missing person Riley Strain? We have a nun, a stepsister, and Charlie Chaplin's The Time Traveler film. What does that have to do with missing person Riley Strain, please? Nun, stepsister, and Charlie Chaplin's The Time Traveler film. Someone may have been seen here. Okay, we're moving into some other territory here. But we have this has to do with someone here that causes a lot of terror in people. Otherwise known as a TERRORIST. We have someone's nun, their stepsister, maybe seen here with either a phone of some kind, or this is someone here, because we have both a school, SHOOTER here, and we have a TERRORIST. So clearly someone here is up to no good. But I do feel like we did get some interesting messages, guys. We got some interesting messages. And I have to say, some of those messages really kind of resonated with what I was seeing in my reading. They really did. And there are some things to think about here. Okay. So thank you guys for tuning in. You know, let's keep it. Let's bring Riley home. Let's hopefully we can find him. Hopefully the police can find him, or the investigators can find him. Like hopes and prayers, thoughts and prayers to the family, his poor mother. I feel so badly for her, and the father, of course, they loved him dearly. So let's bring Riley home and let's find him.